It's finally announced. It's finally announced. Wrong announcement. That's better. Nintendo is back, baby. Yeah. Now how do I get down from here?
It's a vlog.
After many leaks and so many mock imageries, it's unbelievable. We get to finally see the new console handheld hybrid thing that Nintendo's working on, which is called the Nintendo Switch. Switch, hey, that Will Smith song. But yeah, which is understandable why they called the Switch, so you can switch in between the console and handheld. Even though it's kind of a powerful handheld system, even though that, you know, Nintendo's been trying to compete with the mobile marketing as it is, even though it's quite, not saying powerful, but you get what I'm trying to say, people are still speculating how powerful it is, let alone most things as it is, even though it kind of somewhat runs Skyrim, so to say. But even Bethesda themselves said themselves that, oh, we're not kind of working on Skyrim on the Nintendo Switch. Oh, that's a bit of a shame, really. But it would have been cool, though, if Skyrim came onto the Nintendo Switch, because I was thinking about getting the Skyrim Special Edition next week, and I was like, oh, should I wait or should I not? But when I heard it was not kind of officially confirmed, I was like, oh, doesn't matter then. But still, however, I'm really looking forward to the new Zelda. Let alone, I don't know how much the Nintendo Switch is going to be, because people are still speculating, and, you know, when... seeing how much it can is, let alone breaking the bank as it is. Well, to see enough near launch. Anyways, hi, I'm Steamwalking Steety Films. It's a vlog. I was close to doing my outro, you know, when I do the wave and then the point thing. Let alone most things as it is, because at least you guys kind of know now why I do the wave thing as the greeting, let alone. You know, when I did the whole vlog thing, it used to be vlog. If you're a long-time subscriber, you already know about that. Let alone most gestures that I do, let alone at least most things you know now. So yeah, what videos I did this past 1 week. It's been my 10-year anniversary on YouTube, and I kind of did like a Did You Know Gaming parody of, you know, my YouTube channel as it is. It was fun doing it, though, and letting you guys know on certain things during when I did all those things for... You know, 10 years now, which is great, even though that to most things, not saying you would know, but, you know, things have evolved throughout the years on most things. But yeah, it was a fun video to do, nonetheless. Sorry if I'm rambling too much, but you get what I'm trying to say. It was great, though. I'd like to thank all you guys for commenting and giving me some likes on the video. And, you know, it's been great, though, doing it. And, you know, 10 years is quite a lot, even though, funny which... I should have mentioned about that on the video, but I was still on the spot recording it. I was like, no, it's not sensitive. What's the other word? And I was trying to figure it out. But then again, like I said beforehand, YouTube has been a bit sensitive lately, let alone getting offended very, very easily. That was the words I was looking for. Getting offended quite easily with most things. Even, like I said, myself, I get a bit sensitive, let alone offended quite easily. But, you know, I've grown myself now. You know, YouTube and the internet as it is. Thanks, internet. You know, how it is, really. But overall, yeah, it's been great doing YouTube for 10 years now and still carry on and what I do and stuff like that, let alone doing vlogs as it is, you know, rambling too much if you know what I'm like. But, you know, it's comfortable doing YouTube, you know, talking about various things in front of the camera. Because if it weren't for YouTube itself, I would not communicate as I am today. Because you can tell by my game... You know, not saying social skills as it is, but, you know, my speech in general has somewhat evolved throughout the YouTube videos I do. Anyways, enough about that, but you get what I'm trying to say. It was nice to do that video overall. And also, Battlefield 1 came out this past 1 week, and I actually got it, even though it already came out early access for, like, EA access and, well, as well as the early edition, where you spend an extra few pounds to get early, which seems still a bit stupid, really. Games should stop doing that, really. Spend a bit extra just to play it early. But regardless, it was enjoyable playing it, even though it was just yesterday in general, picking it up, doing a video and playing it. Even though that last night in general, there was like some technical issues on certain sites. That was fun. But I still managed to play some of it before I went to bed and all that. But yeah, it was just fun to play some Battlefield 1. And yeah, like I said before, I love playing Battlefield. And I enjoyed playing the beta, though. Hopefully, once Adrian sort himself out, because I haven't been speaking to him much lately, And hopefully I'll get to play some Battlefield 1 with him and have some good times. Yeah. But yeah, speaking about that with Adrian, I haven't done a podcast this week yet again with some certain things. I would say though, but that I don't want to build controversy as it is, so I'm a good person like that. But other than that, you know, Adrian has been, you know, doing this and that lately, so it's understandable why he hasn't done a podcast this week with me. But overall, yeah, so yeah, those are the videos I did this past 1 week. So for this vlog, I thought I'd share some things I got this past 1 week. Don't worry, it's not like a pickups video type thing. Even though I'm going to do like a part two of some certain things I picked up last week, even though I picked up some things this week, which I'll show you guys in a bit. But yeah, first of which, I want to show you guys that something happened quite recently that happened. And I'll try and keep this long, short and sweet as possible. But it's something to do with my good old Windows phone. Yeah, my good old Windows phone. But yeah, I just had like an issue. It's something to do with my headphone jack. And it kind of got broke, so to say. That's the long story short version. Because it had, not saying problems, I thought it was my headphones. Because these are the previous headphones I use. And, well, somewhat current I use. I had them in my drawers recently because I wanted to keep them still. Because they still work. Because after realising, why are you trying on your iPod? Like, oh yeah, you know, I did realise I still have an iPod. And they work on my iPod, so I know it's not my headphone. So it's because of the headphone jack on my Windows phone that's just got broken. Even though, funny which, my mum actually said her phone headphone jack has got busted. So, yeah. I never actually had that experience where basically the headphone jack just went, you know, just gone. Let alone, you know, this is now like an iPhone 7 now without the headphone jack. It's still somewhat working, it's still in limbo. You know, it just would not activate like the remote type thing, you see. And I've just been having problems, you see. And I know all the other headphones work, so it's not just my headphones, it's just my Windows phone in general, you know. Even though just quite recently, I ordered this on Amazon. And that just came in the post just today. I only just put it on my phone. But I'll show you that I had on my previously is what I'm trying to say. But yeah, this, it kind of cracked because of the headphone jack on my previous back cover. And I ordered a new one. That only just came just today. And it feels like a new phone, a fresh new phone. Even the buttons feel new as well, which is quite nice. So I got a brand spanking new back cover that only just came today, surprisingly. Good old Amazon. But yeah, I didn't share on social media because it's not much to share, really. But I did share this, though, and share my experience with this. And I thought I might as well invest and thought I'll try out Bluetooth. See what the kerfuffle is about. Because I know there's some people that use Bluetooth, and I know loads of people in town that I see now and again that use the wired headphones as his. So yeah, I kind of invested and recently got this past 1 week some Bluetooth headphones. Yay, this is my very first Bluetooth headphones. And I picked School Candy still because I had the, you know, the previous ones for many years, you know, and they still work. So I still kept in School Candies, even though that's, I think these been out for a few months in the UK because I was doing some research, knowing me, before I purchased some things. And yeah, I just purchased them. And my experience just like changed like that since I got these Bluetooth headphones. Because as soon as I got them out of the box, and having, I still got the wires and all that in here. But as soon as I switched them on, connected to my phone, and just like, whoa, my experience has just changed when using Bluetooth headphones. And it just feels nice without the wire. You know, because with the previous headphones, just getting them out again, you know, I always have them accidental issues when it comes to the remote. And I needed headphones with the remote so I can switch songs when it comes to when I'm walking and stuff. So I always have them accidental problems, even though you just like do this because there's like volumes and all that and switches and dials. So you can switch songs quite easily. It's just like boop. And it's just brilliant though. And it's not saying I was a bit concerned about Bluetooth, well, in battery life as it is. I just didn't know if to get some or not. And like I said, these are my very first Bluetooth headphones, although most Bluetooth devices is, which I'll get round to the minute, which is my Pebble watch. But, you know, just it just changed my experience completely, let alone these headphones have like 15 hours of playback. And I don't use, well, I go to town quite a bit, but usually my town experience are usually like 2 hours and then just go straight home. So adding the numbers up, you know, I got like a week's worth of battery life. And as soon as I took them out of the box, well, I got them this past 1 week, and using what battery juice that's left in here, I still had some battery life, and I did have any issues, like any connection drops or anything like that, you know. And it's been a great experience overall. And I only just charged these just yesterday, and I got a week's worth already. But yeah, and even though that's my friends from Sheffield actually commented when I posted an image on Instagram, and he was like, "What's the sound like?" And I know there's loads of people who are quite picky on their sounds, let alone them having a good sound experience as it is. But I'm not much of a sound expert, but they do sound quite good, let alone school candies as it is. That's, you know, I always had previous school candies and they always turned out quite good, even though I had some issues on previous headphones, which I won't say. But, you know, after having them headphones and getting these headphones, they do sound quite good. The only drawback that I had with these, low and Bluetooth as it is the connection issue, because there was some, skip track, well, you know, just like some lag, you know, just interfered with my music, but not that very much. Maybe it's because I was walking or something like that, maybe disturbed the connection issue, but other than that, though, it was flawless, though. And the other funny thing is, though, I was unsure if it works on Windows Phone, even though that it's quite a common thing now that most things work on smartphones. And I was quite, because there was not much information on the internet when it comes to Windows 10 Mobile, let alone the Skullcandies as it is. But I was doing some research during me, let alone purchasing these in general. And even though I had this conversation when I picked this up at the store, I had a nice conversation with this person about various things. And I was mentioned to him about, there was not much YouTube videos about, I might do a YouTube video on it. And he was like, "Oh, do you do YouTube?" I was like, "Yeah, I do." And all that. It was a nice conversation overall, let alone that Monday as it is. And when I picked these for headphones, I've had some nice conversations with some various people in town. It was good, though. It was a good enough topic. But you know what I mean? It's great experience, though. Even though I might do a YouTube video of let alone Bluetooth connection as it is, because there's not much YouTube videos about Windows Phone as it is. But it's great, though. It actually works, though. Even though the only reason why I wanted to get new headphones but more Windows Phones, because I'm too lazy to transfer onto my iPod or my music onto my iPod, let alone iTunes as it is with a good old syncing or whatnot, good old Apple. But yeah, overall, in a nutshell, so I've been burping quite a bit. I just had some lemonade because I drank all the cola yesterday, calling cola. The headphones are great, and I'm just going to stick with Bluetooth from now on with headphones as it is. And they are quite good investments, because I got them in a store for £60, and they go for like £80. But yeah, you get your money's worth, let alone the £100 price mark of headphones as it is. You know, once you go Bluetooth, you never go back. And I'm enjoying it, though. So these are my new faves. I'm trying to hug them, you know, new faves of headphones. So yeah, I'm quite pleased with the investment, and plus my first Bluetooth headphones as it is. Speaking about Bluetooth stuff as it is, like I mentioned before, I don't have that much Bluetooth stuff as it is, let alone my Pebble watch as it is Bluetooth. But I realise, after tinkering with my phone, and just, I had this app on my phone for quite a while, and I actually got some working, so to say. Maybe it's because there was two different types of Bluetooth signals you can get on the Pebble watch, and I actually got working. I finally got my Pebble watched the work on my Windows phone, mostly for the notifications. That's why I wanted working. And I had a really good experience this past 1 week as well, using notifications on my Bluetooth, Pebble Watch. And yeah, it just works good. But the problem is I had an issue with the vibration and it didn't work when my mum was texting me and I missed out on the feed text. And then I had to factory reset it and it's like, oh, you need an official app. Oh, because I deleted it off my iPod. And I'm like, oh, screw you, iPod. And now I'm like, oh, I need the iPod app now, the iOS app. So I reinstalled the thing and I realised now, after doing some tinkering, I can switch between my Windows phone for notifications and my iPod so I can, you know what my watch face is and whatnot, even though I love this watch face, knowing me. But yeah, I had issues with that, but I got somewhat working now. So I can switch between my Windows phone and my iPod. But yeah, I don't want things to screw up. But yeah, it's nice that I can actually use notifications now on my smartwatch. I can finally use a full advantage of using a smartwatch, although I don't use notifications as it is. But it does save a bit of battery life if I set it to airplane mode, and that way if I'm not using it, you know, Bluetooth-wise, I can just switch on Bluetooth. It doesn't have a touchscreen, you know what I mean? It's just, yeah, I can just activate Bluetooth. And when I'm out and about, I'm going to switch it off and it just saves a bit of battery life so I can get a week's worth of that as well. So I get used to charging this each week, let alone, you know, charging my Bluetooth headphones each week, let alone routines and all that and changes of his, knowing me. But yeah, overall, I'm just pleased that my Bluetooth, Pebble Watch, smartwatch as it is, works now. So on my last vlog, I picked up some stuff from my good old PlayStation and I picked up some PlayStation pickups and whatnot. But this is kind of a somewhat part two, so to say, even though that this past 1 week I kind of picked up something. Because long story short, when I was dabbling on my devices, knowing me, and checking up on websites to check on prices and various things, when I was checking out some PlayStation related things to see if there was anything else to pick up, I noticed a certain thing gone up value because of the PlayStation VR and whatnot, and that is the good old PlayStation Move. As you can see right there, I already got a PlayStation Move as it is, because they go for, them PlayStation Move controllers go for like £30 to £40 because the value went up extremely high because of the whole PlayStation VR. And I was like, wait a minute, I'm sure, because knowing me, I kind of got good memory and stuff, I'm sure they were like £12 in CEX. And when I was dabbling on the website, I was like, whoa, that just went up way up, you know. And then I was like, because the funny thing is though, I was watching some PlayStation VR videos since it was kind of a thing that people have been posting lately and all that, let alone people that are watching my subscription box, let alone YouTubers as it is. So I was like, I got a PlayStation Move, let's play some PlayStation Move games. And I was like, and all that. And then I thought to myself, if I do go out and about, because there are other stores than, you know, CEX and Granger Games or whatnot that do them PlayStation Moves like £30 to £40. If I ever do go to like a cash converters or a cash generators or any sort of second hand shop, I'm sure they'll be quite cheaper. And funny, which I actually found one very cheap, £8 to be in fact. Sorry for the labelling and all that, but basically this is from a pawn broker shop, a pawn shop, whatever. Because there was this pawn shop that I go to now and again, but I go to this other pawn shop whenever I go down the street, because I usually go down to that street every fourth night when I go to the charity shops, because I do this thing every fourth night, I go to the charity shops. And there was this pawn broker shop down when I look around the charity shops. And I spotted this, and I was like, instant buy, because I know they go for quite a bit, these things. I even mentioned to the guy at the counter, the pawnbroker shop, I was like, oh, these go for like thing, and it was this other guy, and I was like, "Oh, you're getting it for PlayStation VR?" And he was like, "Yeah, PlayStation VR." Like, well, if I ever get PlayStation VR. But yeah, overall, it was great to get this at £8. So if you do have like a pawnbroker shop or a cash converters or cash traders or some kind of secondhand shop, if you do see this quite cheap, do buy them. And surprisingly, it does work, so to say. Yeah, as you can see, the blinking light works. Let alone certain things I got from cash converters don't particularly work. But I'm actually pleased that this worked. So yeah, I'm pleased that I actually got this for a good price at £8. And yeah, it's nice to get a second one. Even though that recently I got that, and because that thing, that stands thing for my PlayStation Move, is actually a charge dock. If I recall, I actually got that for like 50p in a gaming store. But yeah, it was a nice purchase. And I actually recently got that hooked up so I can charge these now and again if I wanted to. There's, I don't know why, but you know what I mean. It's just nice to get that all hooked up and start playing on my PlayStation Move stuff again. I don't know why that keeps on blinking. Stop blinking. Stop blinking. Anyways, but yeah, as soon as I got this though, I thought I'd pick up some PlayStation Move games, because I've got some PlayStation Move games, but I haven't got that many, so to say. So I went to my local Granger Games and I picked up some PlayStation Move games, and I wanted to get this game for quite a while. I have played the demo, if I recall, I did some gameplay of it, but I got Sorcery, which is a nice, yeah, stop blinking now. But yeah, I actually got Sorcery, which is a nice game, and I thought I'd pick this up. Because I didn't know when to pick this up, but I thought, might as well, since I got a PlayStation Move, an extra PlayStation Move, I might as well get some more PlayStation Move games. And it was nice though to get this. And the funny thing is though, as soon as I picked this up from Granger Games, I had a conversation with the guy at Granger Games, the staff member in Granger Games. I went to CEX, and I was like, ah, oh, since I got two PlayStation Move controllers now, I might as well get a game that utilises two PlayStation Move controllers. I was like, oh, I wonder if they have to fight, because I know the fight has, like, somewhat uses two PlayStation Move controllers, let alone knowing PlayStation VR using them sort of things as well, which I mentioned about stuff like that in a bit. So they didn't have the fight in CX, so I went to back into Granger Games to see if they had the fight, so they did it. But instead, though, I kind of got Sports Champions that utilises the Gladiator, and plus I haven't tried the archery, but I tried the Gladiator thing that utilises two controls, so that they do both work, so that's good though, that they both work. So yeah, I actually picked up some PlayStation Move games and while I was at it. But yeah, overall, it's nice to get two PlayStation Move controllers. So if I ever do think about getting their PlayStation VR, then that's sorted though. Even though people have been saying that they're not as good as the like touch controls for like the HTC Vive. But you know, it's a great investment though. Even they go for retail because they're known Sony to resell them, learning old technology as it is. They go for like £60 to £70 in a bundle for two controllers. Learning in most bundles as it is because of the PlayStation VR, learning old technology as it is. But yeah, overall it's nice to get this though, while since after the value went up. So yeah, I'm actually pleased with this though. So yeah, those are the things I picked up this past 1 week. Well, then pickups as it is. But yeah, overall, what I've been up to this past 1 week, I've been fine and dandy. It's just that I've been getting used to all the changes that have been happening with me. I would not say well, then the internet as it is. But yeah, let alone this past 1 week alone, me and my mum recently ordered something last week, and it came this past 1 week. It's nothing special though, it was just basically something to put in my kitchen, alone replacing things as it is. Like I said before, how many times I've been redoing the house, alone ordering things to replace as it is. Even though this past 1 week alone, me and my mum went and like shopping and went to a certain store to get something replaced in my gaming room, which I won't say, but it'll be nice to show that once I get order, what not saying order, I mean once it comes. I have to wait for a month for it to come, which I'm looking forward to. It'd be nice, so a nice change to put in my gaming room, let alone like I said, just game stuff replaced, because I do have like stuff for like over a decade that needs replacing, let alone other things that I would say, but I don't want to say anyways. But yeah, just that in general, I've just been fine and dandy. I did a while to say, really. I don't want to ramble on too much slowly and burping and coughing as it is. Yeah, sorry this vlog was a bit awkward, let alone, you know, just showing what I've been doing recently and all that. But I'm looking forward to most things for the end of the month, including, I might discuss about what videos I'll be doing next week. So yeah, what videos I'll be doing next week. As I said beforehand, about the whole headphone thing, you know, there's not much videos about YouTube, about Bluetooth headphones onto Windows Phone, mainly Windows 10 Mobile. I might do a video, known how-to videos that do quite well on YouTube and whatnot, for people to watch and plus maybe check out my other YouTube videos as it is. So I might do that as like a filler-type video regardless, even though that Skyrim is coming out next week, the special edition. I've been looking at some YouTube videos, but the comparison type videos are like, oh, it looks really, really nice. Let alone mod support as it is, because the reason why I would like to get, let alone playing Skyrim as it is, I enjoy playing Skyrim. I would like to play it again on a newer console and whatnot. Let alone, I know most people play Skyrim on PC, mainly because of the mods on PC. But no, I'm not much of a PC gamer, but I would like to get the special edition that comes out next week. Even though, as I mentioned quite briefly on my opening video when I got Battlefield 1, I was unsure to get Titanfall 2. I enjoyed the beta regardless, I enjoyed it though, but I was unsure about the things that they changed with the Titans. They might change it after the beta, but I'm still unsure really. You know, the whole, it's hard to get a Titan, and hard to spawn a Titan than it is killing a Titan, let alone it was easy to spawn and kill a Titan on the previous Titanfall game, is what I'm trying to say. So I might not have much fun, and there's no point in getting two good shooters, and because, like I said, I enjoy playing Battlefield as it is. And plus, it'll save a bit of memory, since I'm really low on memory on my Xbox One. I will do a big slot out there, but I don't want to delete various games, you see. But I will be getting, maybe, ask for Christmas, a 4 terabyte hard drive on my Xbox One, maybe, because I would like to invest in something like that on my Xbox One. I might ask that for Christmas, maybe, to upgrade my Xbox One's storage. But regardless, I'm really looking forward to the end of this month, let alone, like I said, I'm sure to get Titanfall 2. I might get asked that for Christmas as well. Maybe ask for Titanfall 2 for Christmas. But we'll have to see how the reviewers and the... It's just, like I said, I was unsure about the gameplay. But I enjoyed the beta regardless. It's just certain things, like, changed since the first game is what I'm trying to say. But yeah, that's my thoughts in general. Then I might just get Skyrim next week. Next week as it is. Even though I'm really looking forward to Festival of the Lost next week Destiny, the Halloween special for Destiny. So I'll mostly be playing that most of next week, let alone most games that is. Hopefully I'll enjoy the rest of the week and hopefully to play Battlefield 1 with Adrian and whatnot. But yeah, I'll just cut it from there. I don't want to ramble on too much, let alone discussing most things as it is. So yeah, hopefully enjoy this vlog and watch to the end and understanding. I know you guys have a nice rest of your weekend since I'm recording this on Saturday, since I bought Battlefield 1 yesterday and whatnot. I know you guys enjoy Battlefield 1, let alone most games as it is have been coming out lately. You know, games I would have got, but I haven't got around to getting, you see. So yeah, hope you guys have a nice rest of your weekend. Do not forget to follow my social media, social networking sites of what I've been up to. I know you guys haven't. I'll let you guys get on with your rest of your day. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steezy Films.